So, hello everybody, welcome to just a casual first view of Diablo 2 Resurrected. So I actually didn't play the beta and everything, because I don't really, you know, believe in pre-ordering these days. I guess you kind of learn from that when you pre-ordered Warcraft Reforged. So I never really did get to play the beta or the alpha or whatever. First impressions are very positive. Everything I kind of assumed about the game seems to be true, which is really cool. Anyways, I wanted to start the video here highlighting some performance as we go along. This is just the performance viewer from Nvidia. Everyone has this if you also have a Nvidia GPU. I don't know if AMD actually has the same sort of thing. The only thing it doesn't really seem to show, maybe it's because I have a pretty old system, is FPS. But there are some cool things in the menus that I'll go over in just a little bit. I want to start off here also by telling the help section. This is actually very cool. I can't remember if the original game had this, but it just gives you a quick overview of the most important things, especially the short keys. So even someone like me who tends to forget them can quickly learn about them again. Press shift plus 1, 2, and 3, 4 to give build to a potion. To give build potion to your mercenary. Pretty good to actually learn about. But I don't think a lot of people would know about it if this little help menu didn't pop up. Also, big creds for Blizzard giving text to speech and also colorblind options. It's very cool. I think that's very nice, at least. But yeah. I also want to talk a little about save profiles. We already knew that save profiles was gonna work. But yeah, it's working. So this is just my standard Blizzard Sorceress. Man, it's funny to look at the icons. Some of them are also really dark. I don't know if this Ormus robes. Yeah, it looks a little bit grayed out. But yeah, some of the icons definitely, you kind of just want to, okay, so that's how it's gonna look from now on. Where others are a little more clean, I would say. I really like the look of the skillers here. Small chumps are also somewhat okay. But it's funny to look at the icons and everything, definitely. But yeah, they said that offline profile was gonna work. So again, if you want to test builds out, you can do it yourself with Hero Editor. Or you can just, you know, download my builds. I have, was it 35 of them in total or something like that. Good day. You can also see that the texture speed is in the chat. I think it's like everything about that is great. I really like that. It's just the small little things. Some initial things though. Honestly, the graphics are not that great. We can maybe go out here and in Bloodmoor. Honestly, this is full. I think I put it on everything maxed. Yeah. Then I also took maybe I should remove my frame target. I can perhaps just try to remove that one, see if it matters. But yeah, everything is completely maxed out. Again, my system is very old. I have like a 6-year-old computer or something. So, yeah. So I guess the resolution actually did help a little bit removing the target. Yeah, so it got a little bit better now that I removed the one, but I can also tell that it maybe got a little more choppy. So I honestly think that if you're gonna play, again, this is not a very demanding game, even at high settings, but if you're gonna play it, you might need like a GTX 1060 and like an 6th generation Intel CPU. To really get that smooth 144 FPS with high settings, because I can see that it's running quite choppy right now with my older system. I'm just gonna say that I would have to turn down the settings as it is right now, because I feel like it is a little too choppy. Some funny things here, you see that the potions are quite clear on the ground. You can kind of easily see items. I quite enjoy that. Another thing I also think is that you can actually increase the font sizes of items on the ground. Again, I want to highlight these accessibility features because they are pretty important for me at least. Well, maybe not very important, but I like them. I'm not really that colorblind myself, but I have used settings for that in other games before. So, yeah. I want to go over here some more settings. But first, let's start with the controls. I like how the controls are literally just ripped from the original game. There are no changes to controls. Keybinds works exactly how they were before. And I appreciate that. It literally even looks like the same menu. So that's a good thing that it didn't change that. There was something else. Oh yeah, of course, auto gold and auto pickup. You can remove that if you don't like it. That was not the one that I wanted to show. Oh yeah, show life, orb and text and mana. Before you had to click on the little orbs to highlight them. It's nice that now it can just be default because I always want them showing. Allow online chat. Okay, it is 2021. But the cool thing is with the Diablo 2, I have played it for a lot of years online and I have rarely ever had anyone being a dick in the game or whatever. Like if you open maybe modern FPS games these days, it would maybe be a good thing to not have voice chat enabled or whatever. But yeah, chat font size, you can actually change this. And I think I can just quickly show now here on extra large if it really did change much. Yeah, okay, it changed a lot. So extra large is actually extra large. It's pretty cool. I can also just type something like this. And you can see like how big it is now. And yeah. Where was it again? Sorry, I forgot where I was at. Oh yeah, there you go. So let's try and go down to perhaps medium. Boom, like that's very nice. I like that. Good job, Blizzard. Was there anything else I wanted to highlight? Oh yeah, subtitles, very good. I just want to highlight them because I actually like watching English movies also with English subtitles. Just again because they don't know how to mix audios in movies or whatever. And it's a bit the same for cinematics. It's all that like muffled sound and everything. Was there something else? Oh yeah, cursor sensitivity, that's perhaps a little fun thing. Oh yeah, auto map size, so you can actually change a lot about the maps, the auto map now. The map always got a lot of, hate in the original game. A lot of people really don't like the world map, mini map, whatever you want to call it, in the game. At least I read a lot of, like I tend to go into comment sections on social media and just kind of stall people about something, like read their, see their opinions and whatnot. That's kind of like a good way to get feedback on something I'm interested in. So yeah, I think the conclusion is that the minimap is still maybe not that great, but it's definitely better. Anyways, CPU utilization, GPU utilization is very good. My GPU is also not rising in temperature. It's always sitting at that 68 degrees, like when I'm playing most other games. GPU power is also like at the normal 150 watts or so. Fan speed is also normal in my case. So it seems like it runs pretty well. So I think next up, after having shown you most other things I perhaps wanted to talk about. Yeah. Oh, this is funny. Immune to cold, immune to physical. Okay. Yeah. Oh man, I can really see. Okay, so it's, yeah. Makes me not sure if I have to turn down a little bit of the settings here. Maybe it's a little too loud. Don't want to risk that. But yeah, for now I think we're gonna end this video here with just a casual little chaos run clear, just for the fun of it. But yeah, that was pretty much the initial look. Again, I think for now it runs okay, even on my older system. But again, you might want a better computer than I have if you want to play this with like high frame rate, high settings. Still, everything seems to be what they promised. There's no real thing that I can say right now that doesn't seem to be what I think they were promising back when they were first talking about living up to the original game and whatever. So yeah, we will move on now. Okay, so I'm noticing that the loading time is pretty slow, at least first entered. Yeah, I have to say I also installed the game not on my SSD, but my hard drive instead. Like you see now the loading time when you change to a new act, it's slower than I see in Diablo 2. So this is also a case where you might want to install this game on an SSD. If you don't like that slow loading time when you change to like a new act or whatever, like let's try it now, go to River Flame. Now I'm in Act 3, so let's change to Act 4. When you change act, so you hop in waypoints in the same act, it's not very slow, it's pretty much the same. To a new act, it's slow. So that's funny enough. But yeah, consider installing on an SSD then. That might save a little bit on loading times. Again, I hate loading times. Like, it's... like, in 5-10 years, it's just gonna be gone in games. We already saw that now with the PlayStation 5 or whatever. But yeah, consider installing on an SSD then. Wow! Oh, it's smooth! Okay, it's nice. Okay, it actually runs well. Okay. I mean, this is like the ultimate test. Hello! Just spamming teleport, not really dropping in frames, GPU utilization still at 100%, CPU 40, 20, jumping a little bit as things are happening on the screen, but yeah. No, this is actually very smooth. Damn, okay, Blizzard, you actually, wow. Okay, I mean, again, I am playing on high settings, and I'm saying it feels smooth right now. Like, it's hard to, of course, show the smoothness on video, compared to how I'm feeling it as the player when I record. But yeah, this feels really smooth. Also have to say I have my editing program Discord, a few tabs in Chrome open at the same time. And yeah, it feels very smooth. So that's actually a big surprise. But for now, let's stop talking and actually get playing. Fully buffed Blizzard Sorceress. Let's see if I can remember how to play this. I have two, because this is what I'm also going to be playing online when I make my first little character there. So, I think Q, yeah, Q Blizzard, let's go. This should be very easy. Fully geared Blizzard Sorceress. Wow, it just melts, yes? Until I meet some Oblivion Knights. So I actually never did understand why in the guide that I did for my Blizzard Sorceress back then, why I didn't add like a, yeah, a backup spell. This was more a full Blizzard Sorceress, which was a bit stupid, I suppose. But it's fun to see how good it actually looks. The Blizzard is very pleasing. I mean, this looks actually very cool. Honestly, it actually looks quite good. I think some of the models are a little gray, a little dull to look at, like it's not very popping. Where others are more colorful, interesting to look at. Like take this Elite here, good shadows, good reflections, it's actually very cool. I think the Venom Lords are pretty shitty to look at actually, I don't really like those. In terms of clutter, I don't think it's very overwhelming to look at either. Yeah, I can get used to this pretty fast. I don't think it's very distracting with the more visual spells and everything going on. Yeah, I think this is not very, very hard to adjust to. And my GPU is still utilized at 100%. Temperatures are the same. Okay, so I dropped some frames as the mobs were coming to me there. So yeah, it's a little bit of a problem still playing this game on high settings. But I should also just get a better computer. Stop complaining. Man, I really need a backup spell. But yeah, this is also... I chose this build for myself specifically because I wanted to just get some quick... what can you say, sessions going before I make my own my first online build. Oblivion Knights. They are gonna be my worst enemy on a Blizzard Sorceress. But it really is insane just how much spell or how much damage Blizzard does when you're like kitted out like this. What was that at? Oh my god, 16k Blizzard damage. Yeah, I'm not gonna be doing that on the build that I'm going to roll for the next month or whatever. But yeah, boom boom, look at the Infinity Merc. Like, this is why you really just want to get... Oh, never mind, sorry, this was... Okay, so even in inside Mercenaire, when it's a really good inside, it's actually strong enough to handle those maybe easier mobs and so on fast. Okay, for some reason I thought I was using Infinity on this guy here, but yeah, that's also something I concluded lately, that besides a Hammer Paladin that also uses a lot of mana, the other build that I would also use an inside on would actually be a Blizzard Sorceress. And this is where I, talking, you know, strictly end game, strictly best in slot. Of course, you want to use an insight on literally any build early on with no gear and so on. But strictly end game, best and everything. But yeah, let's maybe finish this up a little bit fast. Man, the teleport just feels so smooth. It honestly feels better to teleport in this game than... Diablo 2, what the fuck? I don't know if they improved it or... It just feels better to teleport straight up. It's so much better to teleport in this game than... wow, it feels different almost. It's like if you lubricated a bike chain. Like before, your bike chain, your bike and everything ran pretty well. It was okay, but then you lubricated it. And you just feel the difference, right? It actually, for some reason, just feels much better to teleport. Wow, Glacial Spike also does a lot of damage. But yeah, I think this is also the build that I'm gonna run. And then I don't think I will go Fireball. I think instead I would try Lightning. And maybe respec around level 40 or so. Because I think I want to try Frost Nova. Maybe Fireball Frost Nova early on, and then when I get a little higher into the levels, then I will respec to Blizzard and Lightning. I think that could be fun. For some reason, I don't think I'm gonna do Frozen Orb, not on this like budget gear here, because I don't think Frozen Orb has quite enough damage at such a low gear level. Maybe I'm wrong on that. I actually don't know if Blizzard works fine enough. Just look at how they melt. Literally one Blizzard. It's funny, man. Blizzard has so much damage. It's really, really strong. But yeah, this is extremely high gear level as well compared to what we are all gonna be running for a really long time. I mean, for a really long time, this is gonna be like best loot. Like, if you find a fresher with a lot of sockets on it, let's see if I got lucky. Okay, so that's only three. But like, this is a really good item. Like, if you found this with some sockets in inside, sorry, how many sockets did an inside need? Oh yeah, four. So yeah, if this had been four sockets, you would have been very happy right now. But like, yeah, this is unrealistic to get. So obviously, but yeah, it's fun to see just how strong it is compared to what we will be running. But yeah, let's just go and see how much damage a single Blizzard does to Diablo. Three ticks and it's down. Yeah. Like, there's no reason to make this build ever. It's idiotic to not have a backup spell. But it is fun when you do a sorceress build that is only specced into a single elemental, just to really get overpowered. But yeah, that's pretty much it for my first... look at Diablo 2 Resurrected. I'm actually very positive right now. I think it runs pretty smooth again. Maybe install it on an SSD, get a better computer than mine, whatever. But I'm really pleased with the... Man, the teleport. It feels really smooth for some reason to teleport in the game. But yeah, this is very promising so far. And you know how negative I'm usually about Blizzard. So for now, I do actually feel like they live up to some of the expectations. You can maybe also criticize them a little bit on the pricing. I think 40 euro is still a lot for essentially the same game with just a coat of paint over it, the original game. But for now, if you're interested, you should actually buy it. I think it gets my recommendation for now. And yeah, for now, I'm really positive. It's actually cool.